Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. Friends, welcome back to my channel. What is operational amplifier? In this session, we will see the baseline of the theory of operational amplifier. From today, I am adding a content in my channel for linear ICs. All the electronics is divided into two portions, analog, digital. In analog circuits, amplitude, signal polarity will increase or decrease linearly, like sine wave, sawtooth wave, triangular wave. And in digital circuits, we have just only two levels, low or high, 0 volt, 5 volt. Let's suppose 5 volt, 10 volt, 15 volt. This circuit will switch its output amplitude either low or high. There is nothing between these two levels. But here, the signal level, signal polarity, amplitude is increasing or decreasing linearly. There are multiple levels between each step. In analog circuits, there are different type of compositions, audio amplifiers, video amplifiers, different type of analog circuits, AC circuits. Here, digital electronics, arithmetic circuits, logical circuits, TTL circuits, ECL circuits, programmable circuits, memories, FPGA, PLDs, all that items which involve digital levels that are categorized here. In analog, we will discuss op-amp, microcircuit linear, linear amplifier. Almost above the 95% circuits contain operational amplifier or comparator, either in power supplies. When we discuss PWM circuit, in each PWM IC, at least there is one, two or more operational amplifiers, comparators. These ICs will deal with varying amplitude. These will compare the signal. These will amplify that signal. And these will decide based on that voltage levels. I will not go in structural theory. I will discuss working concept to build a baseline for our upcoming videos so that we will discuss each and every parameter of operational amplifier and comparator, because it is not just only one IC, it is a complete branch of electronics, complete science, complete theory. So understanding operational amplifier is more complex than a digital circuits. What is amplifier? Let's see, I have a transistor here. It is connected to any collector resistor. There is some signal and we connect here ground. When we apply any signal from any sensor, from any transducer, its signal level is increasing from 0 volt to upside, like this. And maximum it will reach to 1 millivolt. This 1 millivolt will cause to flow current base to emitter. It is just example. We apply 5 volt here. This 1 milliampere current will cause to flow 100 milliampere current here. We applied 1 millivolt, it caused to flow 1 milliampere current. This 1 milliampere current caused to flow 100 milliampere current in the collector. So 1 to 100 ratio. When this current will flow, we will receive dropped voltage here. Let's suppose 1 millivolt here, 100 millivolt here. It will depend on the current and it will depend on the resistor size. We can say we injected 1 millivolt, a weak signal, but we received 100 millivolt signal. Its amplitude is increased. This is input. When input is increasing 0 to 1 millivolt, and here is 100 millivolt. From 0 to 100, it will reach linearly as this signal is increasing. So its current is amplified, its output level is increased. So this increase is due to gain. This ratio, what is the ratio between base current and collector current? That is called amplification factor. If I apply 10 millivolt, 10 multiplied by 100, that means I will receive 1000 millivolt, 1 volt. Same way, if I apply 50 millivolt, 50 multiplied by 100, 5 volt, 5000 millivolt. At this stage, this is the maximum limit because we have 5 volt here. If you will increase input signal, now the output will not increase because it reached until its maximum supply limit. Maximum input signal can be applied here 50 millivolt. That time it will receive the maximum supply voltage here in the output. Below this supply voltage, when we will vary signal here at input, it will give a shape to that signal with this supply voltage. Linear increase with effect of input signal. It is amplifier. With 1 millivolt, we cannot drive any circuit. But with this amplified signal, we can drive any signal. Let's see example. We have a tape recorder, cassette player. We insert a cassette in the tape player. On that magnetic tape, there is a magnetic material coating. When this coating will touch to the head, that is audio head, that head will decode these magnetic signals into some microvolt signals. That microvolt signal will be amplified through an amplifier, and we will receive audio output in the speaker. We are controlling the gain with the volume knob. In this circuit, we have fixed gain. But if we adjust this resistor, input signal current, that time we will control the gain, amplification of this circuit. So it is one example. In an operational amplifier, we have two power supplies, positive, negative. We will receive output. In this circuit, we discussed one input, one output. But in operational amplifier, it is a special circuit, that is this circuit, that is integrated in this IC. This circuit is composed of different transistors, resistors, different sections, input section, buffer section, then it will compare the signal, then it will shift the level, and finally it will provide amplified power signal here in the output. Two different supplies, VCC and VEE, negative voltage and positive voltage. Two inputs here, positive and negative. When we see operational amplifier, practically we will see in this IC shape. Either it is 6 pin, 8 pin, 14 pin, whatsoever. When we see on diagram, we will see a triangle like this. One output, one power supply, positive, negative, and two inputs here, marked as positive, and negative. These are positive voltage, supply voltage, and these are two signals here. One is called non-inverting input, and this is called inverting input, negative, positive. Basically, it is input type, and these inputs will define the role of this IC. When we apply input signal here, it will compare the difference of these two signals, this signal and this signal. Let's suppose we connect this signal, this input pin to ground, that is inverting pin, and we inject any signal from any sensor, from any transducer, from any device, 1 millivolt positive. This is zero level now, and this pin is now 1 millivolt positive. When 1 millivolt positive, it will compare two levels, then it will decide that this pin is in higher side, closer to this power supply side. It will amplify. When we were discussing this circuit, we have limitation that gain of this transistor is fixed. It will reach up to a certain level, then it will not increase more or more. But the feature in this circuit is that when there is a minor difference, even in microvolts, its output will keep multiplying again and again, again and again, until it will touch to the power supply, upper side or lower side. If this pin is positive, we can say 1 millivolt. 1 millivolt is very high amplitude input signal, 1 microvolt. This 1 microvolt will cause to amplify until it will touch to the maximum level. We are applying, let's suppose, 10 volt. 1 microvolt difference will provide 10 volt in the output. If this pin is in negative with respect to this input, that time it will touch to lower side power supply. Amplification will increase until infinity, until the limitation of the power supplies. In operational amplifier, if there is difference between both inputs, amplifier will provide infinity gain. So that gain must be controlled. So in operational amplifier, there is a feedback, negative feedback, that is connected to the inverting pin. A portion of that signal is provided here, that is called feedback signal. So it will control the gain. When its output is increasing and its circuit is calculating, and it is now providing amplification. From that amplified signal, we take a portion to reduce the signal level so that we will receive a fixed gain, which we define with this feedback loop from here. Feedback loop is connected here in this way. If I will apply 1 millivolt, I will receive 10 millivolt. When I will configure this circuit to provide gain of 10. If you will design this feedback loop to provide 100 millivolt with 1 millivolt change in input, that time its gain will be 100. What is the role of these inputs? Invert, that means to make opposite direction drive. Non-inverting, that means there is no inversion. If this signal is increasing in this direction, the output will increase in this direction. If input signal is decreasing, the output signal will decrease. If this signal is at ground potential, plus 1 millivolt, and gain of this circuit is 10, that time with the change in input signal, we will receive 10 millivolt, that is 10 gain. If 1 millivolt drop, 10 millivolt drop. But if we will make this pin as a reference and we inject signal here at inverting input, that time, if this signal is increasing in this side, that time output will decrease. If this signal will decrease, the output will increase. We will design this circuit practically and we will compare these features, these roles of the circuit. If you see this design, it is a one portion of this IC. LM324 contains four operational amplifiers. So it is one portion. That means similar four circuits are incorporated, integrated in this IC. If we design the same IC with discrete components, might be its size will increase than this paper size. So as a final conclusion, as a final wording, we can say operational amplifier is a circuit that will compare two different voltage levels. It will compare them, then it will amplify them, then it will provide output based on the specified gain, which we define in the output side. We can control the gain by adding these components. There are calculations, there are different examples. We will see that configurations, examples, calculations, and we will see theory and practical. I hope this video is informative for you. If it is good, give a thumb up. If you have any question, please write in the comments. Thanks for watching. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.